In this video, part 1, episode 2, the patient returns to the pharmacy for his annual medication assessment. This video will demonstrate how a pharmacy team prepares for and completes an annual medication assessment service with a standard patient. The pharmacist follows a systematic process for interviewing and assessing a patient's medication and health conditions, then effectively provides education and recommendations if any changes to therapy need to be made. The pharmacist works in collaboration with the patient's physician and relevant healthcare providers during this process.
I've come to my appointment with the pharmacist.
Okay, sure. What was your name?
John Ronald.
Oh, right, John. Yeah, I see you right here. The pharmacist is just busy for a sec. If you just want to take a seat, and I'll let him know that you're here.
Okay? Yep, thanks.
Barry, John is here to see you.
Oh, excellent. Great. Yeah, thank you.
And here are the forms that you need.
Good. Thanks. Yeah.
Hi, John.
Hi.
Under me, Barry?
Yep.
Yeah, that's great. We've got an office over here, so let's just walk over here. Okay. How are you today, John?
Oh, pretty good.
That's good. Good. Thanks for coming in. So I just want to review with you what we're going to do today. It'll take about 30 to 45 minutes, and we'll just go through all of your medications one by one. Make sure you're using them in the right way. Make sure there aren't any unexpected problems. And working with you just to make sure your medications are the best for you.
Okay.
I have quite a few forms to fill in, and I know I gave you a couple to take home with you, so I'm hoping that you have those with you.
Yes, I do.
Okay, and did you bring your medications in as well?
Yeah, they're all here.
Okay, well let's take a look.
All of them, I think.
Okay. Great. And do you have the form that I sent?
Oh, yes, I do.
Okay, great. Thank you very much. Okay, great. So you've completed this. Let's see that. Okay, so you're interested in just knowing more in general about your medications.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. Okay, so as we go through this, I'm going to be filling in some forms, and I'll try not to let that interrupt our interaction here.
Okay.
And I do want to start just asking you one thing. If we can accomplish one thing during this interview, what would you hope to get from it?
I'd like to find a way to remember what to take when, as there's so much that I'm taking.
Okay, yeah, so we will get to that for sure, and we'll keep that in mind. I'll ask you some more questions about that afterwards.
Okay,
so let's get started then.
Okay.
So, I just want to find out a few things about you. Do you smoke?
No.
Okay. Do you drink any alcohol?
No, I don't actually.
Not? Okay. I have down that you take a multivitamin, and did you bring that too? Okay. Do you take any other vitamins?
No, just that.
Okay. Any drug allergies?
Sulfa drugs, I think.
Sulfa? Okay.
Make me sick to my stomach.
Okay. How long ago was that? Have you?
Oh, I can't remember. I just remember that what happened.
You just avoid it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, some people forget to take their medication sometimes. How about you?
Yeah, I get a little mixed up sometimes.
Oh,
and
do
I'll
you?
Forget. Yeah.
Okay. How often do you think that happens?
Well, I don't know, maybe over a month of half a dozen times somewhere in that vicinity.
All right. So that's okay. Thanks for letting me know that. And we'll work on that as we go through this next little while and see if we have some solutions for that. Okay. Okay, John, let's go through each of your medications one by one here. Can you just grab the one for your high cholesterol?
It's this one.
Great. Yeah, so simvastatin. And when do you take that?
I take it in the morning.
Okay. And is this one of the ones you forget to take sometimes?
I forget them all sometimes.
Okay, great. How long have you been taking this?
Oh, man. Years.
Years? Okay. And any side effects?
I don't believe so.
No? Okay. You know, there is a side effect that some people have with this medication, and it's not always a people don't always realize it's caused by this one. And that's like achy muscles and not...
No, I don't... No, okay. Not really.
Okay. I have a copy of your blood work here, and I see your cholesterol levels. I'm just for us to decide together what your target range should be for your cholesterol. I'm just wondering, have you had a heart attack in the past?
No.
No? Okay. Has your doctor talked to you about your cholesterol levels, what they should be?
I know they haven't been at some point. They haven't been where they're supposed to be, which is why I'm taking that thing.
Right. Okay. Do you know the numbers for?
Not off the top of my head. I don't know.
Okay. So the bad cholesterol is called LDL. So that's the bad one. And your levels in April were 3.0, and in July 3.1. So for somebody like you, your age and the other risk factors for a heart attack or stroke and how cholesterol affects that, we know from quite a bit of information that if we could get your LDL level, the bad cholesterol level, to about 2, that you'd have a much lower risk of a heart attack or stroke. Okay? Mm-hmm. All right, well, we're going to come back to that afterwards. So let's just move on now. And can you show me which medications you take for high blood pressure? Mm-hmm. Great. So now we've got a good understanding of all your medications and you know a lot about them. So that's really a good start. Now let's just go and make sure we haven't missed anything. So this will help us make sure there's no side effects we haven't thought about and make sure that you don't have any anything wrong with you that could be treated and isn't. Okay?
Okay.
So any problems with your eyes or your hearing? How about sinuses? Like
no.
Okay. In your mouth? Okay. And
yep.
How about breathing? Any problems with your lungs?
No.
Okay. All right, that's good. So even not a problem with getting short of breath when you're exercising and walking?
No.
Okay, that's good. How about your bowels? Any problem with going too often or not enough?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, John, so that's great. We've got a good idea about all your medications and I've gone through, make sure you don't have any side effects. So I think there are two main issues that we can address here. Okay, so the first one, let's talk about why you came, or one of your goals as you came in today was to do better at remembering to take your pills. Okay?
Yeah.
So can you tell me a bit more about that? Have you tried anything to remember?
No, I haven't tried anything special, no.
Okay.
Just hope that I remember.
Yeah. So are there days when you, like certain times or certain days?
Well, it might be if I'm really in a rush or busy and then I can't remember whether I, say, took the simvastatin or whether I didn't and I don't want to take 2.
Right.
So I just hope I took it and maybe I didn't and off I go.
Okay. Well, that's not uncommon. It's happening a handful of times. So I think you're making a reasonable decision to make sure you're not getting a double dose. So that's good. So I think there are a couple of options that we can use here. It's not a bad idea to use a calendar and just put a check mark every day when you've taken your dose and then you know if you've had it or not. And there's something else that quite a few people are using, and it's called compliance packaging or bubble packaging or bubble packing. Have you heard of any of that?
Not really. No.
So some people, when they get more medications and are having trouble to remember, we can package into a square card, and there's a separate spot or bubble for each day and the time of day. So if you have, if it's Monday, and then you've got your pills there, and you just pop out all of Monday's doses, and then you know that you've taken them. Okay.
Okay.
So I'm just, what do you think about that? Would that help?
Probably would, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So I think we should do that. Now, you already have these pills like this. So I think when you finish these, or a few days before you're going to finish these, give us a call, because it takes us a little bit of time to get these packed up for you. And then we can do that and have it ready for you when you come in.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Now, The other thing I want to talk about is your cholesterol levels. Your goal or your target where we would like to see that number is about 2, okay? So right now it's at 3. And you know, I wonder if it might have something to do with missing some of these doses of simvastatin, okay? And you know, this drug in some people, it works a little bit better when it's taken at bedtime or supper.
Oh, okay.
So I think that's a good plan. How's that sound to you?
I guess so, but you're gonna do this packaging.
Yeah, so we'll do this packaging after you finish these vials, okay? When we're getting close. You give us a call a few days before you're going to run out of these. In the meantime, I'm going to talk to your doctor, send a note to her, and let her know about the change in the time of day for the simvastatin, okay?
Okay.
And that we're trying to make sure, or we're trying to reduce the number of times you forget your doses, okay?
Okay.
There are other options if this doesn't work. We can increase this dose, or we can switch to another stronger cousin of this in the same group that helps lower cholesterol.
Okay.
Okay, John, I'm just going to leave myself a note here to make sure that I don't forget to see you again. So with the change in the simvastatin and the packaging to make sure you remember your medications or help you remember your medications, I think we should have a follow-up visit in about 3 months.
Okay.
I will include a note to your doctor to get a cholesterol level done before that so we can see if these changes have had any impact.
Okay.
So it'll be sometime in the middle of February. Do you want to choose a date right now?
I don't think it'll matter. Just whatever works.
Okay. Let's, let's say February 15th.
Sure.
Okay. We'll give you a follow-up reminder beforehand just to make sure.
Okay.
We'll give you a call a day or two before.
Okay.
This next meeting won't be as long because I have a good understanding of your medications now and what your needs are. So it'll be about 10 or 15 minutes probably. We'll still come over here where it's a little more quiet and out of the hustle and bustle and have a good chance to talk.
Okay.
Okay, great. Anything else?
Nope, I guess that's it.
No other questions for me?
Nope.
Okay, that's great.
Okay.
It's been really nice to get to know you a bit better, John.
That too.
Okay.
Thanks. Bye.
As demonstrated by this video, the medication assessment is an in-depth look at the patient's medications and health status that stands to benefit patients in the community by ensuring appropriate, safe, and effective drug therapy. The pharmacy team begins by providing a reminder courtesy call the day before the assessment to ensure that the patient remembers the appointment. Additionally, the pharmacy team prepares for the assessment ahead of time by printing the patient's medication profiles and all the necessary forms and documentation. The pharmacist reviewed the patient profiles prior to meeting to pre-screen for any obvious problems or concerns and to help guide the assessment discussion. During an annual assessment, the pharmacy team may have to modify their workflow in order to accommodate the pharmacist's absence during the duration of the appointment. During the assessment meeting, the pharmacist begins by reminding the patient about how the appointment will proceed and what the goals are for the meeting. Next, the pharmacist requests the patient's main concerns with his medication or with his health in order to target issues and focus the discussion. Next, the pharmacist gathers an in-depth medication experience using the pharmacist interviewing techniques. The medication experience includes acquiring a complete list of prescription and non-prescription medications, confirming the appropriate medication administration techniques are being followed, matching of medications to validated medical conditions, and collecting information regarding past medication allergies and intolerances. Next, the pharmacist goes into more detail about each medical condition using the clinical information acquisition phase. The purpose of conducting the complete and detailed medical history is to ensure that the patient is aware of what his medication is for, how to use his medications, and to actively screen for drug therapy problems or concerns. The pharmacist may require lab data or additional information during the assessment as part of the drug therapy screening process. The pharmacist may acquire this data online from local health portals, or may request this information directly from the patient's healthcare provider to be sent over before the next appointment. The pharmacist may require a short period of time during the assessment to review drug information resources while conducting the assessment and completing recommendations. Next, the pharmacist conducts a head-to-toe review of systems, ensuring that no major health issues or drug-related problems have been missed. In this scenario, the pharmacist communicated all drug therapy problems and recommendations with the patient in terms that are easily understood. Additionally, the pharmacist communicated any findings with the patient's physician or healthcare provider. The patient is provided with an up-to-date medication list for their own records that reminds them which medications they are using and the instructions for their use. Finally, the pharmacist decided that a follow-up appointment was necessary to track the effect of any changes made to drug therapy. Certain criteria may prompt the need for a follow-up appointment, which can be tracked by the pharmacy team.